What should I do?
Ah, ich weiß.
Hallo und willkommen. Ich bin Meister Lenzi and this is Vlog Dave and you're watching German Idioms in Real Life Part 2. In this series we'll explain idioms, German sayings in funny situations in real life to you as the learners. How amazing is that? Let's go. Lasst uns anfangen.
Oh ja.
Hör mal den Teufel nicht an die Wand. Der malt den Teufel an die Wand. Mal den Teufel nicht an die Wand means don't draw the devil on the wall and is used by Germans when we want to say it's not going to be that bad, don't over-exaggerate, don't draw the devil on the wall, you know, it's not going to happen like that. Nah, similar to that. Mal den Teufel mal nicht an die Wand. Mal den Teufel mal nicht an die Wand. Come on, don't draw the devil on the wall.
Bald ist der 21. Dezember. Die Welt wird untergehen.
Ah, mal den Teufel nicht an die Wand.
Ey, geh mir nicht auf den Sack.
Don't go me on the sack. Translated literally, which means don't go me on the nerves. Don't go onto my nerves, so to speak.
Why are you doing this? It's a cute sack with a little Shiba Inu inside, so... What kind of person are you? Fahren wir heute ins Disneyland? Fahren wir heute ins Disneyland? Fahren wir heute ins Disneyland?
Geh mir nicht auf den Sack. Ich hab gesagt, geh mir nicht auf den Sack. Den ganzen Tag gehst du mir schon auf den Sack. Geh mir nicht auf den Sack.
Nein, das ist der falsche Hals.
Etwas in den falschen Hals bekommen. To get something in the wrong neck. This is the literal translation. And we Germans use this when we want to assure that someone, for example, doesn't misunderstand something. Kriegt das jetzt nicht in den falschen Hals. Please, now, don't get this in the wrong neck. Don't misunderstand me. Don't understand it negatively. Because I don't mean it in that way. Or if you do understand something the wrong way, then you get something in the wrong neck. Then you have misunderstood something. Then you have gotten it into the wrong Hals. So don't do that, because that is bad. Etwas in den falschen Hals bekommen. To get something in the wrong neck. When you misunderstand something. When you take something positive and make it a negative. When you see something and take it for the negative, even though it might not be negative. For example, oh, das hat jetzt aber in den falschen Hals bekommen. Oh, he now really got that in the wrong neck. He really mistook that for something that it wasn't. It wasn't meant that way.
Hex, hex!
Jetzt habe ich aus einer Mücke einen Elefanten gemacht.
Aus einer Mücke einen Elefanten machen. To make an elephant out of a mosquito. To turn a mosquito into an elephant. Basically means that something that isn't such a big problem, well, is blown up to be bigger than it is. You make more out of it than it actually is. It's not that hard, not that bad. But you think it truly is and, well, you make a blockbuster out of that problem, so to speak. Yeah.
You make a mountain out of a molehill.
That is true. Ich hab keine Kartoffeln mehr im Haus. Mein Leben ist vorbei.
Oh Mann, ey, jetzt übertreib mal nicht. Du bist echt gut darin, aus einer Mücke einen Elefanten zu machen. Pff, Kartoffeln. Pff. Das war echt klug von dir. Du Fuchs.
Hex, Hex.
Du Mensch.
Ja, und? If you say to someone, du Fuchs, you fox in German, you mean that that person is particularly smart and cunning, intelligent. Du Fuchs. Maybe even a bit scheming. Maybe sly. Ah, sly as a fox. Du Fuchs. You fox.
300 mal 3 sind 1 Million.
Willst du mich verarschen? Hex, Hex! Hey, verarsch mich nicht!
Willst du mich verarschen? Do you want to assify or butterfy me? Do you want to turn me into an ass? Well, because if you do, I'm completely like, I don't know what to do with my life. Willst du mich verarschen basically means, well, why are you doing this? Are you kidding me? You're really surprised, but in a negative way, so yeah, you don't want to be verarscht. Verarsch mich nicht. Don't you lie to me. Tell me the truth.
Niemals.
Yes.
Nein.
Yes.
Nein.
Yes.
Nein.
Yes.
Hier, kannst du knicken.
Ja. Stimmt.
Geknickt.
Das kannst du knicken means in German you can fold this. And as you can see, I did. Das kannst du knicken is if you want to tell someone, no, you can forget about that. Nope, this is not going to happen. Das kannst du knicken. For example, if someone says, ah, let's go to the soccer game tomorrow, football game, whatever you want to say. Nein, da sind keine Tickets mehr verfügbar. Das kannst du knicken. No, there's no tickets anymore available anymore. You can forget about that.
Hey, einem geschenkten Gaul schaut man nicht ins Maul. Don't look a gifted horse into the mouth. Ever. Don't do that. I mean, you got it for free. Why are you complaining? There's no reason. Just be happy with what you got. So, you know, it's a gift. And even a horse. A gifted horse. Well, even better. Bei der Kamera, die du mir geschenkt hast, fehlt der zweite Akku. Was soll das?
Einem geschenkten Gaul schaut man nicht ins Maul.
Hä? Alle Wege führen nach Rom. All pathways lead to Rome. That's a German saying you use when you want to, well, give the impression or tell someone that multiple ways can lead to success. There's multiple ways of doing one thing. You don't have to do one thing the same all the time. There's multiple ways that lead to success. Viele Wege führen nach Rom. Many ways lead to Rome. Or sometimes all ways lead to Rome. Wie soll ich das Projekt nur rechtzeitig fertig kriegen? Soll ich versuchen, mit Tanja daran zu arbeiten oder mit Josh?
Viele Wege führen nach Rom.
Ja.
Aus Schaden wird man klug.
Aus Schaden wird man klug. Pain or damage makes you more intelligent. Questionable, but that is a German saying we use if you want to say to someone, well, I mean, you learned your lesson, right? Aus Schaden wird man klug. This pain, this damage, made you wiser for next time you approach a similar situation. Aus Schaden wird man klug. Oh, ich habe mir beim Fahrradfahren den Kopf verletzt. Ich hatte keinen Helm auf.
Tja, ja. Aus Schaden wird man klug.
Hope you enjoyed these German idioms, these German sayings. If you did, well, you know what to do. Sorry for the hitting.
That hurt.
You, yeah, I know. It was necessary to explain to them, though. Look how much we sacrifice for you. So if you enjoyed this video, leave a like, subscribe to both our channels, Vlog Dave on YouTube, in the video description as well. Social media, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, all of it in the video description. And if you really love the channel, support us by clicking on the join button next to the subscription button or become a patron on patreon.com/getgermanized. And apart from that, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to get Germanized. Goodbye and auf
Wiedersehen.
Das hält die Fresse noch an.